classification and types of entrepreneurs. As discussed in the earlier lecture, in this lecture again, we will be continuing with the classification of entrepreneurs on different bases. So I will begin it once again from the earlier topic onwards. We had seen some 4 to 5 types of entrepreneurs based on various criteria, based on various type of business, like that. So many criteria we had seen in the earlier lecture. So once again, we can do a recap of what we had seen in the earlier lecture. So classification of entrepreneurs, first one is according to the type of business. According to the type of business, we have a business entrepreneur, trading entrepreneur, industrial entrepreneur, corporate entrepreneur, and agricultural entrepreneur. So business entrepreneur is someone who thinks about a new idea, who conceives a new idea, and who starts the business. Trading entrepreneur mainly deals with the trading activities, like they don't much involved in the production or manufacturing activities. They are more involved in the trading activities. Industrial entrepreneurs are those people who are like they are product oriented people who starts an industrial unit for making some new product. Corporate entrepreneurs are those people who is having a corporate undertaking and which is registered under the Companies Act. It is having a legal entity. They are having specialized skills, innovative skills in organizing and managing a big, large scale undertaking. Then agricultural entrepreneur, these entrepreneurs normally undertake agriculture and allied activities like farming and marketing, raising and marketing of crops, fertilizers, and other agricultural activities like plantations, horticulture, even dairy farm, forestry activity like that. It means it covers almost every aspects of agricultural sector. So this was the first classification which we had seen. Second one is according to the use of technology, technical entrepreneur, non-technical entrepreneur, and professional. Technical is someone who is very good as a craftsman and he is concerned and he is concentrating more on production activity rather than marketing activity. Like his skills are mainly for improving the quality of the products. At the same time, non-technical people are those who are concerned more with the marketing activities. They have different strategies in their mind to promote their business. Professional entrepreneurs are those people who is a person, or we can say group of people, who start a business and then they run the business, and after some time they get it sold off or they sell that business and again they start some other venture. They start some other venture with the same procedures, and then this person will not be always interested in managing the business every time. Instead, they will keep on thinking about new ideas, conceiving new ideas for developing different types of projects. Then according to motivation, pure entrepreneur, induced, motivated, and spontaneous. Pure entrepreneur is someone who is motivated by both psychological and economic rewards, like the normal entrepreneurs whom we see. He undertakes this entrepreneurial activity for satisfying his ego, status, and all. Induced entrepreneur is someone who is induced or who is motivated to take this activity due to various benefits which are provided by the government, like various policies which are provided by the government, like tax concessions, tax benefits, various incentives, etc. Then motivated entrepreneur is someone almost similar to that of a pure entrepreneur. They are also into the market for fulfilling their self-motivation, or they are self-fulfilled entrepreneurs. Spontaneous entrepreneurs are naturally talented people. They have the confidence in their ability, and that itself makes them undertake, or that itself motivates them to undertake this entrepreneurial activity. They have a strong confidence in their inborn talent or inborn ability. Then according to growth and super growth. Growth entrepreneurs are those who take up or who deal with high growth entrepreneurs high growth industries, and they always think about substantial growth. They are always positive thinkers and they want to achieve more and more in the market. At the same time, super growth entrepreneurs are people who think beyond that. like they show enormous growth performance in their venture. According to stages of development, we have first generation, modern, and classical. A first generation entrepreneur is someone who starts a business. So usually an innovator. He starts a business or he starts an industrial unit or anything by using different technologies, by using different combinations of product. And from there, the other people will try to imitate him. Modern entrepreneurs are those people who undertake those activities which are already there in the market. And accordingly, they may change as per the market requirements. Classical entrepreneur is the stereotypic, like the normal entrepreneur who is there in the market to maximize his economic return, and that is to make profit with or without growth element. He is mainly concerned with making profit, dealing with customers. Apart from that, we had also seen the small part classification according to area, like urban entrepreneurs, rural entrepreneurs, according to gender, men and women, according to scale of operations, small scale and large scale. This much we had covered in the earlier lecture. Now, this is another topic. This is again very important topic which you have to remember. Classification of entrepreneurs by Clarence Danoff. This is the name of a person. This classification is also very important. Some new terms you are going to learn over here. So according to this Clarence Danoff, we have four different types of entrepreneurs. Innovating entrepreneurs, adoptive or imitating entrepreneurs, Fabian entrepreneurs, and drawn entrepreneurs. So let us see what are these things. First one is innovating entrepreneurs. From the name itself, we can understand the meaning. Innovation means creating something new or introducing something new. So here we can say that the entrepreneurs who are coming under this category, they are highly experimentative in nature. They always think about new possibilities which they can put into practice. Like this type of entrepreneur is one who sees the opportunity in everything for introducing a new technique or introducing a new product or for even for selecting a new market, anything. So they may even reorganize the existing enterprise in order to suit their innovative ideas. So these people are those who always think for creative ideas, always wants to bring something new in both in their enterprise, and they always wants to give something new to the customers. Second one is adoptive or imitating. Adoptive or imitating entrepreneurs, what they do is that they just imitate or they just follow what these innovative entrepreneurs have contributed into the market. In other words, we can say that imitators or these people, this category of people, they just follow the innovations which have been made success in the market. And these entrepreneurs are just imitating the technology and techniques which have been already developed by some other people and which has been successful in the market. And they are important in this group of entrepreneurs are also very important. They contribute a lot to the developing countries' economy because they can easily contribute to the economic development of the country because they don't have to think much. They are always after the innovative entrepreneurs. They try to imitate them and they know what is going to be successful in the market. They observe and study the innovating entrepreneurs, and accordingly they will start their business. Then we have Fabian entrepreneurs. Such entrepreneurs have neither the will to introduce new changes nor the desire to adopt new changes. They are basically we can say introvert type of people. They are very shy and lazy type of people. They are mainly dealing because they have to start a business only for the sake of that they are into the market. Like they just follow maybe running a family business, or they are mainly dealing with the customs, the tradition, the religion, the past practices which their forefathers have started. Such type of people who do not try to copy others, but they somehow want to run the business which might have been started by their predecessors. Drawn entrepreneurs. These entrepreneurs refuse to adopt and use new opportunities and changes in the production. They are so much adamant, they are so much stubborn that even if they suffer losses in their business, they refuse to change the methods of production. And because of this, they always lag behind in the entire process. So drawn entrepreneurs, they are always sticking to their traditional way of doing the business. Whatever new changes are introduced in the market, or whatever, even if something new is shown to them or explained to them, they do not try to accept them. Because of this, they always lag behind in their traditional way. So this is about the classification of entrepreneurs by Clarence Danoff. Innovating entrepreneurs, adoptive or imitating entrepreneurs, Fabian entrepreneurs, and drawn entrepreneurs. Innovative means the person who is going to start it for the first time. They are going to introduce something new. It could be, as I always say in the earlier lectures also, it could be a new product. It could be a new technology. It could be a new method of production. It could be some new group of customers. It could be a new market where they can sell their product. Anything which they are going to do for the first time. Adoptive or imitative entrepreneurs normally observe and imitate, or they follow the innovating entrepreneurs, and they know what is going to be successful in the market. They don't put much effort in thinking about an idea. They only copy. In one way, we can say that they only copy or they follow the successful ideas of these innovative entrepreneurs. Fabian entrepreneurs are those people who are run by traditions, customs, like that. They also hardly put any effort, or they hardly have any desire to introduce new changes in their business. Last one, drawn entrepreneurs are those group of people who are normally very shy and lazy. Even if they are incurring losses in the market, they will not change their method of production or their way of thinking. And because of this reason, they always lag behind. Now, moving to the next important topic here, intrapreneur. Intrapreneur is something, a new term. Till now, we have been learning about entrepreneur or entrepreneur. Now, what is this intrapreneur? Now, what you have to listen, remember here is that how this term began, or how this term was developed. Like in this, actually, we are talking about in foreign context, like during late 1970s and all. Of course, in many large companies, there will be so many experienced senior topmost officers. So many senior such officers of such big companies, they left their jobs and they wanted to start small business on their own, because the management where they were working were not ready to accept their ideas. Now these people became entrepreneurs and they achieved success in their ventures. And some of them even became a threat to the company which they had worked earlier. So this type of people who are beginning from their own company, they are known as intrapreneur. So these are group of people who are a new class of entrepreneurs who might have resigned from their well-paid job, executive jobs, and started business on their own. And some of them even started from their own organization, so that they can be learning things together. And they started applying these ideas of innovation. These people are known as intrapreneur. Now, this is basically a result of corporate brain drain, because people are moving outside. People are moving outside the country. They are migrating. Because of this, many countries are suffering. So here you can see the meaning. Intrapreneur is an entrepreneur within an already existing organization. It is the act of behaving like an entrepreneur while working within a large organization. It is known as a practice of a corporate management style that integrates risk-taking and innovation approaches, as well as reward and motivational techniques that are more traditionally thought of as being the province of entrepreneurship. It means that entrepreneur is, we know who is an entrepreneur. Same way, entrepreneur is someone who is already existing in an organization. Now here you can see the characteristics and qualities of an entrepreneur. You can see over here, it is characteristics, qualities, and all are almost overlapping. almost same similar points. First one you can see innovative ideas. Again, the person who is interested to be an entrepreneur should have creative ideas. Encourage experimentation. Trial and error they would be following. Like almost maybe in the initial stages they may fail also. They may find error. And later on, they will start with a successful idea or strategy. Then initial opportunity, the organization where they are working would be giving them initial opportunity so that they don't face much problem. Availability of resources, finance, human resources, and all those resources, just like whatever is available to an entrepreneur, all these are equally required for an entrepreneur as well. Encouraging teamwork. Then evaluation, the company which they are going to start, that would be evaluated, that would be monitored for a long term. No force, it is something which should come from their own mind. Entrepreneurship is something which should not be forced upon anyone. It should originate on its own. Reward, the organization should even have a system of rewarding to these entrepreneurs so that they are motivated to go ahead. Alteration, the plans which the entrepreneur might be having, it could be something which could be changed as per the requirements. Then support of top management. Top management must wholeheartedly support the entrepreneurial activities. Without their support, we can say that a successful entrepreneur also cannot be created in an enterprise. So though we can see that it could be a threat actually. Entrepreneurs could be a threat to the existing organization. They might be copying some technology, so they might be using some resources which are already there in the enterprise. They might be putting more stress on the people working over there. They might be using the resources for their own entrepreneurship. All those things are there. But who is an entrepreneur? Entrepreneur is someone who is existing within an organization. This is I over here, okay? It should be I over here. It is intrapreneur, not entrepreneur. It is an intrapreneur within an already existing organization. Someone who is already working in an organization, but at the same time, that person is motivated to undertake something new on his own. And many times the companies do support. Many topmost companies do support such innovative ideas, and they do help the people to come up with those ideas. Because many times they do not see such people as a threat, but there were instances where such people are seen as a threat. Such people may even pose challenges for the existing company and all. So if there is support from the top management, it is easier to start such business on their own.